Do you see that, that the DA had made?
Oh, he made this. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah.
That's special. Did they give this to you today?
They gave it to me last week, so I've just been carrying it with me.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That must have been a lot.
It does.
Landon, we are just hours out from the verdict that you've been waiting for 3 years for. What are you feeling right now?
It's a lot of emotions. Happiness, obviously, and the joy that comes along with it. But I also have a feel of emptiness still. It's just you have so many people here and so much support, and just to know that you're per se not normal life, but going back into that transition of your work and all of that, it's bittersweet, but it's also a triumph. It's a victory. So I'm just going to take that with happiness. It's a big present, a gift to so many people other than myself, if that makes sense. And I'm very thankful, extremely so happy.
I'm sure you had anticipated this outcome or prayed a lot on it. But to hear it today, what was that feeling?
Peace, because all I found was peace. For more than three years, I've struggled. You try to put puzzle pieces together of what makes sense, and no matter how hard you try to make sense of it, it never made sense to me. But to hear that the verdict today, guilty, made more sense to me, knowing that that person is going to spend the rest of her life behind bars. It's words that I've been waiting to hear for a very long time.
Hearing the judge tell her straight out, you were jealous of Gannon's biological mom, you, and that he didn't believe her case. When he said your name and talked to her like that, what was that feeling for you?
First of all, I couldn't consider her a mom just for the things that she did, and just sitting there with no remorse, no empathy, and for him, the judge, Judge Warner, to say those words and to basically to tell the story from his perspective and his professionalism just gave me the fulfilling of grace, gave me a fulfilling of my faith has been fulfilled. And instilled a little more trust, because I've lost so much trust in this whole process. But just hearing him say and to tell the story from his perspective, I don't think we could have had a better judge. He done wonderful. And to be there and to hear everything that we've had to hear, I think he was very compassionate as well. And I take that as a blessing.
You've had to hear a lot. 5 weeks of the worst possible things being talked about with your son, with this person that is now convicted of murdering him. Was there a moment that was extremely hard, a harder part than others?
Yeah, there's two in particular that I can't get rid of. One of which is the video where he says, pinky promise. That's all I hear, is pinky promise. And then the other is when she imitates his last breath. That really got to me. I think that was a huge jab, and it just shows you how evil a person could be. That also made me aware of more signs because I try to take people as good people, and that's a flaw. I also think it's a gift, because some people, you don't never know what they go through, and you can try to help them, if that makes sense. But with her, Tisha, there is no help. There was never any help. So those two things I don't ever think could ever go out of my mind. But to have the verdict of guilty, it puts a little bit of comfort on top of it. But those two things just stick out more than anything.
They haunt you.
Yeah, they haunt me.
Being in the room with her for 5 weeks after 3 years of waiting, that must have been tough.
Yeah, it was real tough. You have to look at that person. And she's made eye contact with me a few times, and then it's just like it burns my soul. Like it just just like, how can you even look at me? How can you even look at anybody in the family? Knowing what you did and you still can't admit it is just, she is the definition of coward and evil in my eyes. And the sad thing, 18 stab wounds, 4 blunt force to the head, a gunshot, all of that, Gannon still loved her, I believe, in his last breath, because that's who he is. And I don't want to try to be a biased mom, but my son was different, very different, and she took advantage of it. And she was blessed to even have him in her life.
They talked about how she texted you in those days, the day that he disappeared from his phone. At that point, did you have trust in her?
I trusted her. She was supposed to pick me up at the airport. She was supposed to pick me up at the airport. Little did I know my son's body was in a car in that same airport. Yeah, I was totally blindsided by it all. It was all, great, let's get here. Let's look for Gannon. And when I got there, there was no Tisha. And then even before I left, I felt like something was off with her. And then when I got here, it just really put the bow on top. It's just like, she is the person. And it destroyed me.
To think she did something.
Absolutely. I would have never imagined. I would have never imagined at 11 o'clock, my time, a little bit at 11 o'clock on the 27th, I had to wake up from a phone call saying that my son is missing. I know exactly where I was that day. And that's another thing that will never go away is, you called me, you're telling me that my son is okay, you're supposed to pick me up at the airport, you're supposed to look for my son, and you never did. And the sad thing is, I think that's what took my son's life, is the hate that she had. Nobody should have that amount of hate whatsoever, none. And she is the epitome of evil.
She searched hating your son.
Gannon has told me before how much he loved her. And for her to even compare his name to the word hate bothers me. Because there's not a bone in his body that describes hate. And for her to even say that just kind of depicts of who she really is as a person. And we were all blindsided by it. And that's something that I will forever hold in my heart is, it is guilt, in a sense. It's that, why did this ever happen? January the 7th, the last time I seen my son, I should have just grabbed him out of that airplane tunnel. But I couldn't. I didn't know any of this was going to happen. But today we got justice.
When she did this not guilty by reason of insanity plea, how does that feel for you?
It's a slap in the face. I've known her, gosh, I think a little bit even longer than I've known Albert. Like, we coach, we play ball together, and to say insanity, as all of her life she's said, I'm this person, I'm so great, I don't even know what's true anymore, to be honest with you, because I trusted her. I befriended her. I loved her. And that is the definition of ultimate betrayal. She is a mother. I can't even say that. She's not a mother. She should not even get that definition, but there's more people that are suffering because of this. And you can't show empathy even when your daughter's there. So it's sickening to me.
Did you want to hear from her today in the courtroom?
I wanted to, but I knew I wouldn't. Like, I've prepared myself for 3 years to understand that she will never tell us. And I know that I will probably live this life never knowing. And that's something that I have to carry with me. And I've accepted that. And I'm very blessed that my Lord and Savior can give me some form of peace when it comes to that.
Peace, it seems probably like it's felt impossible after 3 years of what you've been through. So many delays, losing your son, all of this. What does peace feel like today?
You can breathe. You can wake up. Like, I feel like I can wake up tomorrow knowing that my son had a life that is valuable. not only to me, but to so many other people that are in this community, that I can sleep knowing that justice is served. And so many people put so many hours into this, but my son's not just a piece of paper. He's a person. And it has been portrayed by every individual from my family, from people on the defense team, to people on the prosecution, and I'll have to say this, the lawyer, I can't pronounce his name, but Tisha is one that starts with a T.
Trellini.
He even, today, stopped me outside and gave me words of compassion. And that had to be something hard for him to do, but for someone like that to have compassion and the person that you're defending to not have compassion, I feel bad for him. I do. So peace is a big word. I know that my family, my aunt, my mother, my nephews, his friends, his teacher, his parents, his family, everybody involved knows that it's done. That little boy Blue, my hero, G-Man, Gannon, had a voice. He has a story, and it's been told. And peace comes from that because we have victory today. And I only had that peace one other time, and I call it peace that passes all understanding, is when I was on the road to Florence, South Carolina. Albert was driving, and I sat there. After 4 years from that, or 3 years from that, I'd lost a child, and I prayed. And I had a heat that went from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet and said, it's going to be okay. And for the second time in my life today, I have that feeling. That it's going to be okay, that the Lord answered the prayers. And there were too many signs in this case that God was involved. And I'm very thankful for that.
His body being found.
He could have went a day before, 2 months before. Like, he could have just left. But for him to be in that bridge working on that, that was divine intervention. You can't tell me there's not a God or a higher being. Period. And that has, amongst other things, that is one thing that has really made that significant for me, is through my son.
Without that, them finding your son, which I can't imagine how painful it has been having him in the courtroom in a box. But without that, you might not be here today.
Yeah, because you'd still be holding on to hope. I have a church friend back home. He went missing at sea, and they haven't found his body. And his wife just had a baby. And to know that a body, unfortunately, we have to say that has not been found, a family is going to hold on peace, thinking that you're going to walk through that door. And that's a pain 3 years that's going to last an eternity. And I'm thankful for that because it answered a lot of the questions that we would have never known. And it's awful. By God, it's awful. Like, who can disrespect someone so much to drive on the side of a bridge, to throw someone off? That's just sickening to me. Like, how can anybody comprehend that? Like, I can't get it, but I'm blessed.
I think you said something really important today. You've said it to me maybe 3 years ago when we chatted, that this young boy in 11 years in his life has impacted and done so much more than most of us could ever do.
Absolutely. That's another way I find peace, is Gannon at 11 years old has done more things in his short life than a lot of us ever will. Like, I've had letters from all over the world, classmates, parents, family, that have wrote letters saying that, I'm so thankful I've never met your son, but I'm thankful that I have met him because now I value family. I can look for signs. I'll take every little memory as it comes, capture every moment, and just to take a smile as a smile. And Gannon had that. So much love. Like I said earlier, he is my hero. And from the day that he was born, he became my hero, and he fulfilled that cape very well through many people's life, not just mine. And I didn't know this until the case, and this is how I feel like the Lord works, is he plants seeds. And this is just a seed that is planted that I feel like is going to continue to bloom the rest of our life in the name of Gannon and the great deeds that he's done in the community. When I tell you at a drop of a dime, a community, a state, a city came together, I cannot embellish that. Like, I'm still, like, in awe of people coming together. And it's heartwarming.
It's truly special.
And he did that.
He did. There's a lot of things that people probably don't understand not being in your shoes, going through the past 3 years, going through this trial. I'm sure you have learned a lot that you never wanted to learn. Enlighten us. You know, what have you been going through? You didn't even know some of the things at first, right?
None of it. A lot of it I didn't know. But that comes with a case. If people go through this, I would urge you to listen, because you're kind of forced to stay quiet in a sense, because that could jeopardize everything. And being a mom or even a family member, the only thing that you want to do is just get it out. And that's hard. 3 years, you just have to sit here and you hear awful things. People talk. What I've learned to know is the people that care for you, they know who you are. You don't have to explain yourself. And that's for anybody in general, is that be yourself, love your family. Stay close to the ones that love you. Fight like hell. Don't ever give up. Don't ever give up. Hold strength as long as you can hold it. When you feel like you're giving up, just pray harder. Reach out to the people that love you, because you could. It's hard being alone. And I can say during this whole process that I've had a community and family and church people that have came together. In this 3 years, I don't think it would have been a lot worse, but to have the good people, even including yourself, you've been here since the very beginning. And those 3 years it's been awful. You have people asking you questions. I have my four-year-old that is asking me questions. She asks me questions like an adult, and sometimes you don't have the answers. And the only thing that you can do is move forward. Do the best that you can. I'm going to hear his story. But the 3 years have been, it's been awful. You just, every day is like you're reliving that first day. Some days are worse than others. And then some days it's like a roller coaster. It starts all over again. But I'm thankful, and I'm hoping something with Gannon's name, that other people don't have to go through the things that you go through when you lose someone that you love, especially a child. And through this, I hope that there's something that can be done.
A law change or something.
Absolutely. Children are our future, and sometimes we tend to forget that we get more focused on our daily lives and we forget about the innocence that we have right in front of us. And I'm very thankful, for sure. Gannon, Lena, and Nova has taught me more than anything in the last 3 years, and that has given me the peace that I need, along from the support that I've had from very close friends, Janie, Sarah, my Aunt Veronica. 1,195 days. Can we wait it? It's a long time. Nobody should carry that pain, period. And sometimes you just wake up and you're like, this never happened, and then just reality steps in. But having the judgment today that she's guilty can give me some better thoughts.
Do you think it will end that cycle, that nightmare every day, or do you think it'll just make it a bit easier?
I think it'll make it easier, for sure. There's never going to be a moment that goes by that I just wish he would walk through the door. I long for that, but just to know that today is the day, out of these 3 agonizing years, that my son has justice. And without a shadow of a doubt, I know that he is happy. I can see that smile. And that's something that I haven't been able to see. It's like I see the pictures, but it just tears me up. I can see that smile today. And it gives me the relief, for sure.
There's so many things for 3 years that you probably wanted to say, but you couldn't. What would you want to say to Leticia that you weren't able to?
My human side comes out. I need, that's hard. If I could say things to her, I think I've said a lot of it in my statement today. But if she had a drop of love that Gannon had, she wouldn't be sitting there today. And if I could tell her anything, it would be that she needs to get her life right. She needs to speak up. She needs to let everybody else know what they deserve. They deserve to know the reason. I may never know the reason, but she needs to speak up. And if she never speaks up, I know that justice has been served today. And if I look her in my eyes, I can't tell you that I can look her in the eyes without me getting up and handle it myself. That's just human. But I have got to know that the Lord is going to take care of her, and that it says, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord. And I've got to trust in that. Because me being human, I couldn't sit in a courtroom for 6+ weeks without God, without my family, with a person sitting less than 10 yards away from me. I would just ask her why over and over and over. And I still don't think I'd get the answer, though. So I have to leave today knowing, and I'm okay with it, that I may never see her face again, that I'll see my son smile, knowing confidently that this community worked hard, the DA worked hard to convict her, and I'm happy.
I can't even imagine getting up today, talking in front of her, talking to your son, addressing her, the judge. That must have been hard.
It was awful. I woke up this morning, I remember telling him I was shaking. We got the phone call that saying, hey, we need to hurry up and get to the court. And it was kind of a surreal moment. You're like, this is really going to happen. And then you know it's going to be 50-50. Which way is it going to be? And I had confidence that we were going to hear what we hear today. But waiting, that's brutal. It's hard. And with composure, the only thing I can say, it's for Gannon. I would not be able to get his story out. Am I hurting? There's times that nobody sees me, and I'm letting it all out because he deserves my strength. He deserves my love that he will always get. He deserves his story told the right way, and that's the only way that I can tell it. And I do believe, and I know in my heart, that he has been with me every step of the way. This is how he would want me to act. A while ago when you just asked me the question, what would I do if Tisha was sitting in front of me? I had to revert to what would Gannon want me to do. That's what Gannon would want me to do. And I believe that.
If people could take away something from Gannon's story or what you think Gannon would want people to know, what is that?
Love. Love. No matter what. Love took him out of this world. If we can have just a drop of love that Gannon had, this world would change. You wouldn't hear about some of the things that we hear about on the news stations. We wouldn't be hearing the story that we're hearing today if we just had that love. And that word is in caps lock. Like it's imminent, like it's important. It's important for you to tell others that you love them. When you wake up, make sure you tell the people that you love them, because that word, the meaning, it can go a long way. Some people can just be holding on to just a little bit of hope, and that four-letter word, love, can change your life. And that's all that I know. Sometimes I'm a little naive, if that makes sense, but I try to love, and that it's hard to love it sometimes, but once you disperse the love, it becomes contagious, and Gannon has done that.